Welcome to Tekedia Daily. I'm WC Ekekwe. Our conversation today is on anti-corruption technology to eliminate public procurement fraud in Nigeria. Challenges of corruption, there are so many of them. They are actually affecting our ability as a country to develop at the pace the world has actually expected us to do. Corruption affects our national reputation, making it very difficult for some of our business people to actually enter into relationship with other partners around the world. There is also the misalignment of markets, because corruption moves equilibrium of markets from the right place where market forces would have put it, favoring some people at the detriment of others. The competitiveness of our nation will always consistently be affected if we continue to be seen as a country where there are many corrupt people. Nigeria needs to have a strategy to prepare, detect, defend, defeat, and handle its institutions and processes in order to make sure that corruption does not continuously affect ability as a country to develop. You know, over the years, government has come up with some policies and laws to building institutions like ICPC, EFCC, to see how we can mitigate some of these impacts and how we can keep the country corruption-free. But what we believe that EFCC especially has to move from this paradigm of prosecution into prevention of corruption. Most times, it focuses largely on prosecution, when we will say that the corruption has already taken place. How can EFCC evolve, essentially making sure that corruption doesn't even take place so that it doesn't have to actually have people to prosecute? So deterrent and institutionalization of processes to make fraud difficult is going to be very, very critical in the nation. We also have to find ways and use technologies like pattern matching and analytics to do this work. One of the key elements here is that technology readiness, the computational models, you know, mathematical systems that are not largely non-human based, are evolving and emerging, and Nigeria can find a way to leverage them. You know, the Central Bank of Nigeria database, Bureau of Public Procurement Database, there are ways we can use even the policies that exist today and build a technology system to make them work so that in our country, we can largely be corruption-free, at least within the procurement systems. So we are proposing that under the Bureau of Public Procurement, we need to have an integrated procurement fraud unit that can work with EFCC to make sure that we can track every aspect of major procurement in the nation. There is no need to install anything. The system will have the ability to track historical price patterns and also alert relevant stakeholders to follow up if there are discrepancies. You know, the process is this. Can the nation automate its procurement parts? Is there any way we can ensure that all payments have to be digitalized? You know, how can we have a base amount for certain common things that we buy? How can we standardize requests for proposals so that all those discrepancies and variations that actually make it difficult to quantify the value created when government spends money to engage contractors and vendors, we can take them out? So the real-time policing of procurement process and expenses in government is going to be very critical. And by looking at this real-time policy, we can find these deviations and in some cases, offer alternatives in real time to the agencies of government that are making these procurements. So for instance, you have a scenario where someone wants to buy equipment, and that equipment has significantly been extremely, very, very expensive. You know, you believe that that equipment has been inflated in price. So imagine a scenario where instead of going on to approve that particular procurement, you can offer an alternative to that specific agency that another contractor can deliver at a better price. So we see that we have this opportunity to use technology for investigation, for audit, for compliance, for enforcement, for price surveillance, for change behavior, and also monitoring tracks of futures within not just in the private sector, but also really in the public sector. What we are proposing here is today is that IPFU, going to be driven by analytics to track payment patterns and ascertain procurement integrity. It finds inflated or fraudulent procurement system And it requires that the Central Bank of Nigeria must ask that before it makes any payment, it must digitalize every contract in a database. And that database will be searchable, database will have ability that this particular unit will scan through it and understand exactly what that particular agency is asking CBN to pay. And when you do that, a lot of insights can come. And when those insights come, good things happen. So this technology, as it queries and tracks the historical and present cost to see patterns, it can now see that this particular agency is paying for, let's say for instance, a Toyota Camry, 18 million naira, when another agency just bought the same, within the same vicinity for 10 million naira. And they are buying these things within the same month and the same city. It means that the system can raise a flag. And when the system raises a flag, what happens here is that the government, through the IPFU, can follow up to find out if the other manager that is going to pay 18 million naira is just not capable or incompetent, or maybe there is an element of corruption going on. You know, so over time, government would build a benchmark data that provides guidance on what specific things that are constantly being purchasing across the different elements and different arms of government across the country are actually paying for. For instance, if you look through this architecture here, you have the government agency A, B, and C. And whenever they have finalized their procurement process, contracting process with any specific vendor, they have to dump it into a cloud server where analytics and computational models to make sense of everything. You know, there has to be standardized to make sure that we can compare apple with apple and not apple with orange. Now, the Bureau of Public Procurement, through now, use actually technology to analyze and seize all these things. And when it has done everything it's supposed to do, it now allows it to move forward. And when it moves forward, and the procurement fraud unit, we use a historical database to ascertain pricing integrity. It is only when the procurement pricing unit and procurement fraud unit has approved that payment can happen. The goal here is this, that if there is any way somebody is paying for something at a deviation of around 30-40% from what another person has paid for the same item over the last let's say 2 months, the system must have the ability to track it. And when the system has tracked it, the system can get back to that originating agency to say, oh, you are trying to buy this car for 18 million naira, when agency C has actually paid 10 million for the same car. So we will be happy to call the same contractor that supply agency C for 10 million to supply you the same car for 18 million. So the same car you are trying to pay for 18 million for 10 million, you know. So, but the only way government can do this is if government has a kind of a memory of how much it has paid over this specific car. You know, the biggest problem we have in Nigeria is this price asymmetry. We just try to make things extremely difficult for people to understand what is going on. And that is one of the biggest problems why corruption actually exists. Because the Bureau of Public Procurement does not have a history of what it's paying for. And that is the reason why it cannot make a very definitive validation of anything. But now, if you bring technology into it, good things will happen. Now, as soon as the procurement fraud unit has approved, the CBN gets this document. And then the CBN has to now make a requirement. It's very, very critical that anything is paying, it also has to scan it. So what we are trying to do here is that the convergence of the document here and the document here must match. So that when the CBN has paid, this is the actual time that money is being spent. This is the actual time the final document is ready. So you keep that record. You know that you have paid 10 million naira for this car. So there is no reason in next month or 2 months' time, another agency is coming up with something that doesn't make sense. And as we do this, we make sure that we as kind of standardize our processes, bring dynamic ontology, having an ability to do some of these things at scale. And as we do that, we can have the ability to detect fraud, waste, and abuse. And then we can see how we can match budgets, match expenses, and track some of these things that we just continue to struggle over time. It's very, very important that our nation bring technical leadership to see how we can use technology to deal with some of the challenges that we face. And we do believe vividly that a technology that takes into consideration all these elements are going to be vital in our ability to manage some of these corruption issues across the country. It is something that is doable. It's something that is not really very difficult. But all we need is to have the heart of making simple requirements, build better database, build better codes, make a requirement through the presidential directive that all contracts must be scanned and they have an ability to track in real time. Thank you very much for listening to Techidia Daily.